Forever can never be long enough for me. Feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day.
Richer, poorer, in sickness and in health, and until them to your heart. Surely then these words that you will say are more serious. It is a beautiful tribute to your undoubted faith in each other, that recognizing the full importance of these words, you were nevertheless so willing and so ready to pronounce them. And because these words involve such solemn obligations, it is most fitting that you rest the security of your wedded love upon the great principle of self-sacrifice. And so you begin your married life by the voluntary and complete surrender of your individual lives in the interest of the deeper and wider life which you will now have in common. Henceforth, you belong entirely to each other. You will be one in mind, one in heart, one in affection, and whatever the sacrifices you have made hereafter be required to make to preserve this common life, always make them generous. Sacrifice is usually difficult and irksome. Only life can make it easy, and perfect love can make it a joy. We are willing to give in proportion as we love, and when love is perfect, the sacrifice is complete. No greater blessing can come to your marriage life than pure love, loyal and true to the end. May then this love, with which you join your hands and hearts today, never fail but grow deeper and stronger as the years go on. In true love and selfish spirit of perfect sacrifice will guide your every action. You can expect the greatest measure of earthly happiness that may be allotted to a man and to a woman. Our first reading, On Your Wedding Day by Melanie Gibson. Today is the day you will always remember, the greatest day in everyone's life. You start the day just two people in love and end as husband and wife, also in love. It's a brand new beginning, the start of a journey with moments to cherish and treasure, and although there'll be times when you both disagree, be sure to be outweighed by pleasure. You have heard many words of advice in the past when the secrets of marriage were spoken, but now you know the answers lie with the hidden inside where the bond of true love lies unbroken. So live happy forever as lovers and as friends. It's the dawn of a new life for you as you stand there together with love in your eyes from the moment you whisper, I do. And with luck, all your hopes and dreams seem real. May success find its way to your hearts. Tomorrow can bring you the greatest of joys, but today is the day it all starts. Kevin and Sarah, I require and charge you both, having duly considered this covenant you're about to make, that you do not declare to each other before this company your love for each other. That you pledge your faith to your intended, be well assured that if these solemn vows are kept intact, your married life will be happy. Kevin, you take Sarah to be your wedded wife, to live together in a state of marriage. You promise to love her, honor her, keep her in sickness and in health, and forsake all others, to remain loyal to her so long as you both shall live. Likewise, Sarah, you take Kevin to be your wedded husband, to live together in a state of marriage. You promise to love him, honor him, keep him in sickness and in health, and forsake all others, remain loyal to him as long as you both shall live.
I do.
Thank you. Since it is your intention to enter marriage, please declare your consent to this union, Kevin, by saying these words to Sarah. I, Kevin, take you, Sarah.
I, Kevin, take you, Sarah.
Be my wife.
Be my wife.
To share with you,
share with you
the joys and responsibilities of life.
The joys and responsibilities of life.
I promise to be true to you from this day forward.
I promise to be true to you from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love and honor you.
Cherish you.
And cherish you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Sarah, I ask the same of you to say these words to Kevin. I, Sarah, take you, Kevin.
I, Sarah, take you, Kevin.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To share with you.
To share with you.
The joys and responsibilities of life.
The joys and responsibilities of life.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I would love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Good. A little logistics here. Stay where you are. I'm going to swap places with you. And I'm going to ask you two to step behind here. Okay, I'm going to try not to block you. Okay? And those that have cameras would like to take pictures of this. I have no problem with anybody stepping up behind me, going to better view with your camera. But I'll try not to block anybody. Kevin, no, you go behind the... Kevin and Sarah, you have just promised each other your futures. This is a relation agreement between two people who agree that they will commit themselves to one another in keeping their covenant throughout their lives. You entered this relationship as two distinct individuals, but from this day forward, your lives are intertwined for eternity. One container represents you, Kevin, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. One container represents you, Sarah, again, all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. We will symbolize this covenant through the combining of these two individual containers of sand. As these two portions of sand are combined into a third container, the separate amounts no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as the grains of sand can never be separated and divided into the individual containers again, so shall your relationship be within this marriage. More important than your individuality is the reality that you are now joined forever in this union. You have created a greater and more intimate relationship to treasure for a lifetime, in a real and a spiritual sense. You will never be separated one from the other. So now I ask you both, please lift up your containers and jointly fill the center empty. Signifies that it's utterly impossible to separate the sand back into what it was before. It's a warning that this marriage can never be undone, same as the sand can never be undone. So hopefully you'll have a very long and happy marriage, because it's going to take a very long and unhappy time to separate what was just done by you two people.
I'm not worried.
I don't think Kevin's worried. Congratulations. But while you're standing there, we'll do the second reading.
Sure.
The Art of Marriage. A good marriage must be created. In the marriage, the little things are big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you at least once each day. It is never going to sleep angry. Is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together and facing the world. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner. Your family and friends. I have a verse to read, and then we'll do the rings. The wedding ring has neither a beginning nor an end. It is a symbol of endless faith and trust. It is a symbol of love everlasting. It is not only a sustaining power and prosperity, but a comfort in time of need. May these rings ever remind you both of the solemn vows and obligations which you have taken this day and keep you steadfast therein and faithful to the end. And by these rings you symbolize your bond. May their meaning sink into your hearts and bind your lives together by devotion and faithfulness to one another in a mutual self-consecration and an ever-deepening love. Kevin, as you place the ring on Sarah's finger, I ask you to repeat after me. Sarah, I give you this ring.
Sarah, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As I place this ring on your finger,
and I place this ring on your finger,
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I ask you to wear this.
I ask you to wear this.
As a sign to the world.
As a sign to the world.
That you are my wife.
That you are my wife.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee with.
I thee with.
And Sarah, likewise, as you're placing the ring on Kevin's ring finger, also say the amen. Before I close out the ceremony, I just want to say one thing. Again, this isn't part of the ceremony. The words that you heard this evening are not my words. This is a civil ceremony. But the words that Sarah and Kevin created the ceremony themselves. So the words you heard are their words. It's a civil ceremony, but they took the time and effort to create it. Usually brides and grooms don't do that. But they certainly took the time and the effort to put the ceremony together. So it's certainly a very nice job on their part. And of all the ceremonies I've done in 35 to 36 years, they did a very good job. And certainly, when you go through the receiving line, compliment them on it, because they did a very good job. I have a blessing to say, so just bow your heads. It is that mystical bonding that we have come to witness and bless. May the union of your minds produce great ideas together. May you discover revelations of eternal truth. May you never allow your thoughts to be spent on smallness, mediocrity, or regret. Amen. Now, by the authority granted me by the Commonwealth, but most of all by the power of your own love, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now have your first kiss as a married couple.
Thank you. Let's make some noise for Sarah Bruce and Travis Daphanis. Hey guys, let's give it up for Kelsey Gannon and our best man, John Clark. Right now, guys, make some noise for our maid of honor, Joanna Clark and Jeff Crooker. And right now, ladies and gentlemen, we need everyone in the ballroom to please rise. Because at this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce our newlywed couple. I need you to put those hands together, make a whole lot of noise, and help me welcome in our newlywed couple. Guys, let's bring down the house for the new Mr. and Mrs. To gather around the dance floor as Sarah and Kevin share their first dance together as husband and wife.
From this moment on.
I know one day you learn to fly.
I'm
Nation. Once again, let's have a nice round of applause for Kevin and his mom. And Royce Simmons, all from Omaha. So guys, how is everyone doing? Are we ready to have some fun tonight? How many dancers do we have in the room? Make some noise for me. The table by the bar, of course. Sounds about right. Well, guys, right now, I'm going to pick up the energy a little bit in the room. Sarah and Kevin let me in on a little something that, you guys are all a really fun group, so I want to put that to the test and find out how fun you guys are. I'm going to ask if we could just have one person at every table hold up a napkin for me. Doesn't matter who it is, hold it up. Maybe somebody who hasn't gotten the wedding cake on it yet. There we go. Hold those napkins up nice and high. And all we're going to have you do is pass that napkin around the table for me. Any way you want, pass it left, pass it right, you can toss it across the table even. Just don't drop it in the candle. Alright guys, keep it going around that table.
First, I just want to thank everyone for coming, make the day great for Sarah and Kevin. Kevin seemed like he's been a part of family for a long time, and they just made it official today, so. Here's to Sarah and Kevin.
And then, once again, let's have a nice round of applause for our best man and our maid of honor. And I'd like to invite you to enjoy your dinner here this evening alongside the new Mr. and Mrs. Gaffney.
She's not going to say anything else.
We're going to have you carefully feed your beautiful bride for us all. And that's a nice round of applause for Kevin. Sarah, we're going to have you now break off a second piece. And we'll have you go ahead and feed your new husband. She said it, I didn't believe her. Kevin, why don't you give Sarah a nice sweet kiss for us? Give her a nice sweet kiss. And then she wants to put those hands together. Let's hear it for the new Mr. and Mrs. Gagney. Alright, here we go. Brittany, what do we need?
done. All right. Here we go. So get in there, right around them. Scoot your nice big smiles. Show off those pearly whites. Hey guys, ready? I need you to put those hands up in the air. Let's make some noise. Give it a little Mr. and Mrs. Gaddy, guys. Put those hands up. We're looking good. We're looking good, guys. All right, one more time. Let's make some noise for Sarah and Kevin. Since we do have you out here out of your seats, I mean, I said no Macarena by surprise. We're going to start dancing right now. We're going to turn these lights down. Kick this party up a little bit. If you guys have any requests, come on up and let me know. We're going to start things off. A little something that we can all dance to. Get a little something from those 80s.
Stand up.
fiancés, they don't count. Unless you're married, we need you up here with Kevin. And if you're not married, and wear a superhero t-shirt, you definitely need to be up here. Guys, maybe I'll take a couple steps to your right for me. The step right over, we're gonna watch out for that chandelier. Did we miss anybody? Is this all the unmarried ones? So one of these lucky guys, one, two, three. Someone's got it, all right. Well, guys, we're going to have you all clear off the dance floor. Thank you for playing, but you did not win. Sarah, get on up here. We need all the unmarried women now to the dance floor. So let's get on. Unless you're married, we need you up here. So ladies, we're gonna take a couple steps to your right. Just like when you were the guys, gonna watch out for that chandelier. Sarah doesn't want to buy a chandelier for the house. Not just yet, but not that one. So Sarah, if you're ready, just this way. Is this everybody? Are we missing anyone? We're missing a couple. Ladies, get up here. Unless you're married, we need you up here. You gotta think, if you got the invite, she knows if you're married or not. You really can't escape this one. There we go. Just pack this dance floor. And Sarah, you ready? On the count of three, over your shoulder. One, two, three. Fantastic. All right, so to that point, our garden bouquet. Come on over here. We're joking. Grab a seat for me if you could.
You done this before?
You have, okay. Probably not this way. So just so everyone knows, your name is? Joanna, your name? Travis. Travis, do you know Joanna? A little bit. Did you meet her for the wedding? Yeah. So, you know, long bridal party. Just the wedding. A week or so. Okay, we'll go with that. I can't tell if he's lying, but we'll go with it. So, Travis, you said you've done this before, so you know what you need to do. You gotta play Star Guard and join his right leg for us. But since he's done this before, don't you think we should make it more interesting this time? A little more challenging. I like where Kevin's head's at. What we're going to have you is we're going to have you place that garter on Joanna's right leg for us. As you do that, we're going to have you keep two things in mind. One, for every inch above the ankle that makes it on her right leg, we'll measure one more year of good luck for the new Mr. and Mrs. Daddy. Number two, you can't use your hands. So guys, make some noise for Travis. Let's give him some music. Chair out of there. We're gonna keep things going on the dance floor, but right now what I like to do is we're gonna kick it back a little old school. So I want to see how many people out there actually remember how to move their feet, move their hips, and keep that body going. Because we're gonna kick it back, way back. So the little team of our sister guys, I want to get you out here to this dance floor. Move those feet, shaking those hips. And dance like they did back in the 60s.
Man.